I don't like this dress, Qinqin. It looks weird on me. Zhao Lifei frowned, running a tired hand through her hair. There were bags beneath her eyes from the endless nights of tossing in her bed and never falling asleep. Ever since she became the laughingstock of Shenbei, her confidence was at its limits. The haughty twinkle in her eyes from being engaged to Zheng Tianyi had vanished long ago. From losing everything in just the single span of one night, her diva attitude, prideful smirks, and confident struts were all gone. Before the fall of the legendary Zhao Lifei, she was known to be the top socialite of Shenbei. The women always crowded around her, in hopes of currying favors with the rumored Mrs. Zheng. Whatever she wore, ate, and did, everyone copied after her. She was the trendsetter, the single woman that every socialite aspired to be. Her parents swore they loved her. Her friends overly complimented her. The people always tried to befriend her. That all ended when Zheng Tianyi blacklisted and tossed her aside. But after two long and life-changing years, Zhao Lifei didn't blame them. She finally understood how much of a horrible woman she was. She turned women against women, used people like they were a pawn in her little game of chess, insulted girls to tears, and tried to sabotage the innocent Sha Mengxi. Most would say she got what she deserved, but one never saw the truth behind the prideful and spoiled heiress. No one saw how much Zhao Lifei broke down at night drinking wine all alone in a cold, empty room until her tears lulled her to sleep. No one saw that broken child reaching for anything that showed her love. Zhao Lifei was only able to snap back into reality when Yang Ruken roughly shook her. "Fei Fei, I hope you're not daydreaming again." Yang Ruken huffed. She was curling Zhao Lifei's hair in hopes of making her presentable. "I wasn't," Zhao Lifei sheepishly lied. Yang Ruken rolled her eyes. "Sure, and I'm the ugliest girl this world has seen." Yang Ruken resorted with her usual sarcasm. Zhao Lifei chuckled. "Don't be so dramatic, Qinqin. I'm supposed to be a diva, it's my job to be overly dramatic." Yang Ruken laughed, wrapping strands of Zhao Lifei's silky hair over the curling iron. "Besides, my dear, you look fabulous, don't doubt yourself anymore." She smiled, placing her hand onto Zhao Lifei's shoulder. "Okay." Zhao Lifei trailed off, hugging her stomach the way she always did. It made her feel safe. It had been a bad habit of hers after the past two long, rough years of torment. Yang Ruken's eyes softened. When Zhao Lifei had experienced her worst downfall, Yang Ruken was at the peak of her career. Her manager and family forced her to work hard and she was often traveling around the world. She didn't hear about what happened to Zhao Lifei until she had come back. She didn't hear about what happened to Zhao Lifei until she had come back 2 years later. Because she was rarely in the country and was frequently traveling from one country to the other, she barely had time to chat with Zhao Lifei. Zhao Lifei didn't say anything about her downfall. When Yang Ruken came back, she expected a wedding invitation on her hands. Instead, she got the shell of the cheerful woman she used to know. After a while of doing Zhao Lifei's hair, Yang Ruken finally spoke up again. "It'll be fun today. I reserved a seat at your favorite restaurant, La Roche." La Roche was a very popular and posh restaurant that was rated 5 Michelin stars a few months after it opened. It was extremely hard to make reservations there. The restaurant never batted an eye to A-list celebrities, powerful politicians, or wealthy socialites. However, the Yangs were able to gain easy entrance. The owner had been good friends with Yang Ruken's father and had permitted them unlimited entry at the window with the best view. "My favorite. It always seemed to be your favorite," Zhao Lifei teased. She remembered the memories of her youth where she was dragged to the restaurant whenever Yang Ruken wanted to skip class. "I don't know what you're talking about." Yang Ruken giggled, clearly lying through her teeth. Her eyes twinkled with mirth upon being caught red-handed. Zhao Lifei gave her a pointed look, forcing Yang Ruken to reveal a sheepish grin. Okay, maybe I was too addicted to their dishes, but hey. You can't blame me, their appetizers are amazing. Yang Ruken tried to defend herself. Zhao Lifei chuckled, shaking her head in amusement. Let's not dwell so much on the facts. The driver is waiting. Yang Ruken giggled, dragging Zhao Lifei out of her room. The minute Zhao Lifei walked out of her room, she groaned in annoyance. Her living room was very modern and there were large windows from the ceiling to the ground. The sun was at its highest peak today, and Yang Ruken just had to open all of the curtains. Some days, I think you're trying to roast me alive. Zhao Lifei childishly pouted. You need some sun, or more specifically, vitamin D in your life, Tilda, Yang Ruken teased, nudging her the entire time they walked to the elevator. Ha, ha, very funny. Zhao Lifei snorted in the most unladylike manner. Yang Ruken chuckled at her friend's lack of humor, then wrapped her arms around Zhao Lifei's arm, clinging onto her the way she always did. The elevator door dinged to reveal the pretty elevator lady. She smiled and bowed at their presence. To the ground floor, Miss Zhao and Miss Yang. Had this been the previous Zhao Lifei, she wouldn't have bothered to acknowledge someone like the elevator hostess. But this was the present. She wasn't as childish and disrespectful as she was before. Yes, the ground floor, please. Zhao Lifei nodded, offering a polite smile. Right away, ma'am. The elevator hostess said, quietly pressing the button and averting her gaze. The elevator hostess couldn't help but admire Zhao Lifei from the distance. For the 2 years that she had known Zhao Lifei, the woman was always very polite and warm. There was never a moment in time where Zhao Lifei treated her rudely like she was air, as most of the people in this rich apartment complex had done. The hostess didn't know the tainted past of Zhao Lifei, and if one was to tell her, she wouldn't believe that person. This lady was simply too kind to do something so horrible. When the floor dinged and signaled the ground floor, Yang Ruken pulled Zhao Lifei out of the elevator. Thank you, Zhao Lifei quietly told the hostess before she was dragged away by Yang Ruken. When they walked into the lobby and towards the entrance, they were quick to garner attention. With each step Yang Ruken took, her hair would sway and bounce as the wind ruffled the edges of her red sundress. Because of her eyes' feline shape, they always came off as seductive without meaning to. The men leered and took second glances at her, their eyes wide with astonishment. They were practically drooling. Zhao Lifei quietly laughed to herself. She was already used to these looks whenever she walked with Yang Ruken. While Zhao Lifei chatted with Yang Ruken, she didn't realize the men were also admiring the stunning woman beside supermodel Yang Ruken. Zhao Lifei had thought they were only looking at her best friend, and no one else. She didn't expect them to also stare at her. With her high nose of clear wealth, full lips naturally rosy, and fierce eyes, Zhao Lifei's appearance was the opposite of docile and demure. Instead, she looked like a powerful woman that men seemed to fear but secretly admire. Despite what Zhao Lifei thought of herself and her composure, her outward appearance didn't match her thoughts. Perhaps it was due to the years of training and experience, but Zhao Lifei always walked with confidence. Her shoulders were squared back and her head was held high. What is the rush for? Zhao Lifei asked when Yang Ruken hurriedly dragged her inside the car. I'm just excited to eat, that's all. You know I love food, almost as much as I love you. Yang Ruken teased, pinching Zhao Lifei's nose.